My name is Matthew Rocknich. I am a developer evangelist here at DocuSign. I'm here today in sunny Seattle with David Miller, who's a senior software engineer. David, thank you so much for being here today.
Matt, thanks for having me.
Excellent. So David, how long have you been a software engineer?
Long time. I started in high school and luckily just missed the punch card era, but got interested in it and then decided to head for a software engineering computer science degree.
And correct me if I'm wrong, you mentioned that you were also part of different startups, you know, along the way.
Yeah, I started two companies, neither of them, you know, made it, but were fabulous experiences. And, you know, I've kind of since then been in bigger companies and more smart startup type roles and really enjoyed that environment.
So how long have you been developing at DocuSign?
I've been at DocuSign for about a year and a half now.
Excellent. And having been here for a year and a half, what is the best part about being at DocuSign?
Just coming to work every day, interesting problems to solve, working with smart, energetic people. You know, we all work as a team really well, I feel like. So it's enjoyable to come to work, which is not always the case at some companies.
Absolutely. And what is your current area of focus? What are you working on in your team?
I'm working on responsive signing. So I'm on the signing team here at DocuSign, and main focus is taking the API responsive signing into the public front-end application and adding the responsive features to that.
Awesome. So responsive signing, what exactly is that?
So responsive signing is a new way for our DocuSign recipients to interact with their documents. In the past, when they were signing on mobile devices, tablets, or other small screens, the recipients would need to pinch and zoom and scan throughout their documents. It was a difficult process on a small screen. Responsive signing allows you to quickly read and view on any device without any specialized gestures.
So David, what makes the document responsive?
So either through sending HTML through the APIs or us converting PDFs or Word documents to dynamic HTML, we create a responsive document that will fit to either a mobile or a tablet device, expand or contract.
Great. And then the Smart Sections portion, what is that?
Smart Sections allows you to take this HTML and through your documents be able to mark it up and provide functionality, like if you have a long legal document, you can compress sections into collapsible sections. You can put break buttons in there. You can do things like rotate tables that would be a real wide table into a tall table, which would fit on a mobile device better.
Great. And then responsive signing and smart sections, are these features a part of a new API or part of an existing?
These are part of our existing e-signature API. They're a premium feature that you need to talk to your account representative about.
Awesome. So David, can you show us how developers can use responsive signing and smart sections in their apps?
Yeah, absolutely. I've got a good example here. So we're going to start with just a basic Word document. It's got markup in it. We'll see that in a little bit. But this document I put into my Postman. This is the tool I use for doing API calls for testing things out. And so you'll see I've got the binary encoded Base64 Word document in there. That's this right here. And the key piece of information, this is just a create and send envelope call. One of the most common things you do with DocuSign. There's an additional section here called HTML definition, which describes our smart section work, our responsive work, I should say, and says our source is a document. This could be HTML if you're sending a source HTML. And then additionally, I've got a switch on here called show mobile optimized toggle, which allows the signer, when they're signing the document, to switch between either a PDF view or a responsive HTML.
The standard signing experience versus this new responsive.
Yeah, so you can switch between the two. So we can send that and take a look. Okay, so we have our document here, and I haven't done anything to it other than send it responsively. So you can see the toggle switch that I talked about is displayed here. So we can switch between a regular PDF view, which is, you know, pretty zoomed out, and you got to, like we talked about, pinch and zoom to get around it, and a responsive document, which is the HTML that was generated from our source document. And you can see that based on your form factor, it resizes and adjusts to the screen. So now we're going to, so this is a document, it's pretty long, it's got a bunch of information in it, you know, a lot of scrolling and so forth. So we're gonna do some smart section work on that to make it look a little bit better. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna collapse a lot of that text down at the bottom into more digestible sections here. And the way I'm doing that is, again, in this HTML definition, we've got display anchors, which are our smart sections, and we've got start anchors and end anchors, which define within the document. So this text is in the document, which specifies where this section is going to be applied.
Got it.
And then you can remove it from the document, a bunch of other settings that you have there. Additionally, on the display settings, we're going to specify, like, my first section I'm going to say is going to be collapsed, and then I've got HTML to define the actual section that represents that. My second section, for example, is collapsible, which means it's going to be expanded and can be collapsed. So we'll just send this, take a look. Okay, so this is going to be our document with the same document. The only thing I've done is added those sections, and so we'll see how that turned out. So we go down here to the sections. So here's the first section I described in the postman call. It's a collapsed section, so you can see it can be expanded. It was already collapsed.
Beautiful.
Second one is expanded and can be collapsed. So you'll see that all that text down at the bottom has been...
It cleans up quite a bit.
Yeah, but you also notice that we have some other stuff in our document here. This is a header and footer that we're going to take care of next. So a lot of times you may not want to see that in your responsive document. It just kind of tightens up the document a little bit.
Sure.
So we'll go and do that. So all I've done in the next API call, it's again just a create envelope call, same call, I'm just adding things to the previous ones, is I've added a section, marked it with, I think I called it SF for start footer and EF for end footer for my markers within the document.
Got it.
Then I just said type was print only, which means that this is going to display on your final document, your PDF form, it'll still display, but in your responsive, it'll just remove it.
Oh, interesting. So this step, it'll remove that portion of
yes,
the document.
Yes, so we've got all our other smart sections, and we've added this smart section to it. Okay, so now, as we go down here, you'll see that...
voila, it's gone.
It's gone. Yeah, the sections are gone. It's nice
Beautiful.
And clean, so we don't have any of those header and footers in there anymore. So you've got a nice, concise document here that's easily digestible. You can expand the things that you want to read in more detail or not. So this was all the remainder of the document that
Excellent.
Collapsed. Yeah.
Very cool. So for you developers out there that are interested in using and utilizing responsive signing and smart sections, head over to developers.docusign.com. And contact your account manager if you want to pump it up to these premium features. But otherwise, David, thanks so much for being here today.
Absolutely, it was very fun.
Have a good one. Yep, thanks. Hi, thank you so much for watching the video. If you'd like to learn the latest and greatest in DocuSign technology, I would highly encourage you to attend our Momentum conference and hackathon in June in San Francisco. It's completely free for developers.